Waze is undergoing some internal reshuffling at Google, and while the latest report suggests that Waze is not about to go away anytime soon, it might be time to migrate to Google Maps. In this video, I cover off how to use the same or similar Waze features in Google Maps, plus I cover off a few unique Google Maps options when commuting by private vehicle. Google has a history of sunsetting apps and services suddenly. Waze is the latest app to see some internal changes that might inspire users to find an alternative commuting app sooner rather than later. The natural migration for Waze users will be to use Google Maps instead, both being owned by Google and having a lot of similar functionality. While Google Maps includes a vast array of additional features beyond just commuting via vehicle, it is possible to simplify and home in on the Google Maps features that you want to use for the best Waze-like experience. The first step for a trip is to search and set a destination. All you have to do is search for a destination using the dialog at the top and tap your choice. There are quick options available underneath the search bar, broken out into categories if you don't already have a specific business or point of interest in mind. One tip for navigating someone's house or place of business that you already have in your Google Contacts app is that you can simply type their name. This saves looking up the address and having to copy and paste it into Google Maps. Once selected, you then have the option to specify your mode of transportation, which will generate different types of routes and estimated travel times. In the options, you can set whether you want to avoid tolls, highways, and ferries, plus you can set whether you want to specify how efficient the route is for fuel consumption. You can also opt in to seeing toll prices marked on the map and choose your engine type, whether that's gas, diesel, electric, or hybrid vehicle. This will amend your route to accommodate things like the nearest EV chargers. One very useful feature is the ability to add layers of information over the standard map. For drivers, one of the most important options is traffic data in the form of visual representations on the congestion level on any given road. Green signifies road conditions are clear and traffic is moving at a posted speed or there are fewer vehicles on your route. Orange suggests some slowdown or increased activity. Red suggests traffic is moving slower than the posted speeds along the road, and deep red signifies traffic is at a standstill. Once you've set your destination, you can also choose to add a stop by searching for it. Tapping on the spyglass will provide the option to either select a destination on the map manually, your main shortcuts for home and work, or a list of recent destinations. Typing in category or name will bring up the best matches. Tapping on a result will insert a new stop between your starting point and the final destination. If required, you can edit the order of stops by tapping the three dots and choosing Edit Stops. Now you can press and hold the results to drag them into the order that you require. There's also the option to add an additional stop at the bottom in this part of the interface. In the Options menu, you can set your preferred departure or arrival time, which is great for reviewing journey times for planning purposes. Setting a departure time gives you an insight into the traffic conditions beyond your current actual time, as most routes change during rush hour or during the daytime. However, setting the arrival time enables you to plan for arriving on time for appointments, flights, or if you have to catch additional modes of transport, such as a ferry. Another useful feature after carefully planning your journey is the option to add a shortcut to your phone's home screen for quick access later. You could also share the route you create with other people using your shared directions option. Once pressed, you can choose your preferred app to share your created route. There's also the option to share your location from anywhere from 1 hour to permanently with trusted contacts. That contact will then be able to find your location on their Google Maps app via the location sharing menu. Once set up, you can then begin navigation by tapping Start or preview the route in text form by tapping Steps. or save the journey to the Go section on the Google Maps homepage. The Go section is where any saved routes or planned journeys appear for you after you pin them. Here, you'll find suggestions for other recent trips to add to your saved list for ease of access. Just like Waze, you can set your home and work addresses for quick access too. When searching, you'll be presented with two buttons for home and work. Tapping on them when you first use Google Maps will enable you to type in the relevant addresses. If you want to edit them later, just tap on More, and then you can tap on the three dots to change the details there. Once you've plugged in your details, the last Waze-like feature is the ability to choose an alternative route. By default, Google Maps will calculate the best route using your chosen settings, but should you wish to adjust your journey, you'll be presented with alternatives as grey lines. These include details on the travel time and pertinent information for that route. Tapping on them will substitute the current route for the new option instead. Once you've tapped Start to begin navigation, you'll be presented with the journey summary, including the estimated time to the destination based on the road and traffic conditions. For some journeys, you'll see a quick summary of additional route information, including tolls, and additional modes of transport, such as car ferries. While the journey is active, you can still search along the route for any potential stops you need to make. There are shortcuts for finding gas stations, restaurants, coffee shops, and more. Plus, you can simply use the search bar to search for specific businesses or places of interest, or people in your contacts. One useful trick I use is searching for suitable parking around the final destination. There is also a quick toggle for audio so that you can switch the navigation notifications off, reduce them only to the major turns, or have the full turn-by-turn notifications. The compass icon has two functions. By default, with a 3D map engaged, you'll see the map from your perspective facing the same direction as your vehicle. However, if you tap on the icon, you can orient the map to north instead, which can be useful in some situations. Tapping on it again will revert to the previous view. Below that is the icon for reporting different types of incidents on the road for other users, just like the feature in Waze. One fun hidden trick is that you can change the default blue dot that represents your location to a tiny virtual vehicle if you desire. Tapping on the blue dot brings up a selection of three different vehicles to choose from. It's just a cosmetic change that doesn't add any functionality, however. At the bottom of the screen is your shade menu. When retracted, you can see the journey summary details. Tapping on it reveals additional options. However, you can find some of the same functionality already covered earlier in this video, such as reporting incidents, sharing your trip with other contacts, searching along the route, plus there are two quick toggles for showing traffic data and the option to use a satellite image map instead of the default map. Tapping on settings takes you to some of the more advanced options, but more on that later. To the right of the journey summary is an overview button that zooms out to give you a much broader view of the overall journey. In this view, you can review any incidents and reports along the route, plus review traffic conditions more easily in advance. Should you want to reset the map, you can tap on Recenter to jump back to your current location. The lesser known function on this screen is the ability to tap on the green banner at the top that shows your next turn. Tapping on it jumps ahead to the next instruction and plays the corresponding audio notification, which is useful for preparing yourself while driving. Some useful features for commuters include being able to mark your current location as a parking spot. This is especially useful when parking at large malls or long-stay car parks, where, if you're like me, you might forget where you left your car. When it comes to the sound and voices settings in the settings menu, you'll find some more options which will improve your personal driving and commuting experience. For instance, guidance volume is the ability to change the loudness of the audio notifications without affecting the master volume of your phone or your in-car entertainment system. So you can choose whether the notifications are louder or quieter when compared to your music or podcasts while driving. While you don't have the options for fun comedy and celebrity voices like Waze, you can change Google Maps to use your native language as well as either British or an American accent. One note is the default English setting will read out the street names, and the same functionality is not available in other languages in North America. You'll only get turn-by-turn instructions instead. Another useful option is to choose whether the navigation notifications play through your Bluetooth-connected entertainment system or whether they come from your phone. Some users might prefer uninterrupted audio from the entertainment system while driving. Instead, the turn-by-turn instructions will use your phone speaker. Similarly, you can choose whether the navigation notifications will interrupt your phone calls when connected to your entertainment system. If you're in the middle of a call, you won't suddenly have Google instructing you to make a turn or warning you of a change in road conditions. You can also choose whether each announcement is preceded by a chime that announces the next instruction. The final important feature is the ability to switch on Google Assistant so that you can use hands-free voice commands while driving. Activating driving mode will turn on Do Not Disturb and enable you to use voice commands to play music, take or make phone calls, and read messages you receive out loud using Google Assistant. There are some features unique to Google Maps that you can't find in Waze, which are still very useful for commuters. For starters, you can choose more than one vehicle should you be a cyclist or decide to walk or take a ride-hailing service like Uber or Lyft. These have their own unique routing calculations for various reasons, such as using bike paths instead of roads. Google Maps even enables you to hail rides from directly within the app in metropolitan locations. When travelling by public transport, you'll get additional assistance in the form of live updates as you approach the bus or tram stops. Plus, if you have your earphones plugged in, you'll also hear handy prompts giving you forewarning of your final destination so you don't miss your stop. Finally, Google Maps is a really convenient feature that is available using the app on web. When on the web version of Google Maps and after planning a route for the future using the arrive and depart function, you can add the information to your Google Calendar as an event. It will use the time and date to insert an event into your calendar using the default notifications to make sure that you leave on time. On the flip side, there are some missing Waze features I would love to see integrated into Google Maps. The first is suggested travel times visualization. In Waze, you can review the best time to leave for a destination based on the time of day. The graphical user interface is convenient for eyeballing good departure times. Also, I mentioned earlier that you can change the navigation language, but sadly you can't add the celebrity and comedic turn-by-turn directions. Fingers crossed that Google sees an opportunity to add it in the future. Finally, unlike Waze, you can't integrate your Google Calendar directly into the mobile app. You can use the workaround I shared in the last chapter using Google Maps on web, but it would be nice to have your planned trips added automatically when using your phone. Thanks for watching, and as always, please like this video and subscribe to my channel for more videos on the connected home and personal technology.